I hate public transport because I don't like asking for directions. I'm the kind of person who would rather end up at the last stop on the wrong train than ask for help.
But the first time I took the London Underground, I fell in love. Everything was neatly labeled and explained. Every time I had to make a choice as a passenger, like which connecting train I should be taking or which platform I should be running towards, I found help in the form of a map or a disembodied voice. The entire experience was designed keeping me in mind. I reached my destination without asking for help.
I enjoyed the experience so much that I've never considered an alternative ever since. And that is the power of great self-service. To all IT leaders who want to implement self-service in your company, I will say this. Apart from freeing up your team's time by deflecting tickets, a great self-service experience also delights your end users and makes them want to come back for more. In this video, we will explore four steps that will help you implement the best possible self-service experience for your end users.
Step 1. Research.
It is very important to understand the needs of your end users, who are the main stakeholders in your self-service implementation. You can do this in two ways. Create a user group with members from many different teams in your company. Make your IT's biggest critics a part of this group too. Talk to them and find out answers to questions like,
what do they do when they come to the office? What are some of the common apps they use? What do they do when they're faced with an IT issue? And what words do they use to refer to said IT issues? Spend a few hours with members from this group, shadowing them as they do their work.
Identify where your end users spend most of their time and take your self-service there.
For example, if your organization spends a lot of time on internal communication tools like Workplace or Slack, then take your self-service there. The second way to do the research is through your tickets. A simple report on your current ticketing system will tell you the most important issues your users are facing.
This will give you an idea on what articles you need to be working on first. For example, if most of your tickets are about password reset, then implementing a password reset solution should be your first priority. The ideal outcome of step one would be a document outlining your end users' IT needs, the daily working environment, the tools they use, and much more. This would be very useful in step two, design. The self-service portal that your end users will visit to request items from the service catalog and raise tickets will be the first thing that you design. This is easy to do if your ITSM software gives you a fully customizable self-service portal.
More than being visually appealing, the design should make it easy for your users to navigate.
Here are a few factors to keep in mind while designing. Incorporate feedback. If you have the luxury of time,
you can start by wireframing the portal on a mockup tool like Balsamiq and validating it with your user group.
If not, you can build the portal and invite them to take a look. The most important thing is to incorporate the feedback right from the beginning. Make it simple. Since most of your self-service portal will be text, make sure your end users can understand everything displayed on their screen.
Do not bombard them with IT terms without mutually agreed definitions. Help them by providing guiding text wherever possible.
Remember, if they're not able to fill out the form, an email is coming your way. Build a kick-ass knowledge base. Based on your research, you would know what issues your users face the most.
Provide comprehensive solutions to these issues with screenshots or images. Use tools that suggest the right articles when an employee is raising a related ticket.
Building a knowledge base is an art in itself. For more information on how to build it well, check out the link in the description. Traditionally, when you think self-service, you think portal. But your self-service implementation will not be successful if you rely only on the portal, although it does start with one.
You need to take self-service to where the users are. Here's how.
Create a self-service map.
A self-service map is a visual representation of different tools your end users use and the different ways in which they interact with your IT team.
This map would contain information about every team in your company and the various touch points that you can influence.
For example, the touch points of a salesperson are their CRM tool, a reporting tool and the internal communication tool, the emails they send to the IT team, and the in-person requests they make. You can repeat this exercise for all the teams in your company. Design a user journey for each touch point.
Based on a self-service map, you can figure out 3 or 4 major touch points and design a self-service experience for each one.
Mobile experience.
Most ITSM software include a mobile app that end users can download. If you have a mobile device management strategy, you can also install it for employees while onboarding them.
If your company already has a mobile app, you can also explore options for embedding the self-service experience right within their app. Communication channels.
If your company uses a communication channel like Slack or Workplace, Chances are, your end users probably spend a lot of time there.
Find a way to integrate with these apps and deliver the self-service experience there.
Designing and building the self-service experience is only half the job. The other half is making sure people are aware and derive value from it.
Which leads us to step 3, launch. Here are a few techniques you can use to increase your self-service adoption.
Physical posters. Create a simple poster outlining the new self-service experience, highlighting the value prop, how to find it, and put it up across your office.
TV walkthroughs. On the launch day, you can also set up a station with a huge TV and teach people how to get value out of the experience. Company announcements. If a company hosts an all-hands meeting, get a 5-minute slot to talk about the self-service initiative.
Emails.
An email definitely helps, but focus on how the users can get value out of self-service rather than on what you have built. Else, it will go into the user's trash immediately.
Videos.
Work with your marketing team to create a quick video conveying the value of self-service that can be shared with end users or projected on TVs.
Word of mouth. In some teams, nothing drives the adoption of a new idea like a manager telling them to do so.
Call a meeting with the department heads and explain your self-service strategy to them. Convince them to circulate the message internally to their teams.
At the end of this step, you have a complete self-service experience that your end users have started using.
Step 4. Improve.
Most self-service experiences start with a bang and then fizzle out. It will not stand the test of time if you don't invest in updating it and improving it constantly. There are 2 key aspects that you need to improve, and you can focus on them separately. Improve adoption. Your end users need an incentive to adopt self-service into their work routine. There is no doubt you provide value, but do they know what's in it for them?
Focus on marketing what value the self-service approach adds to their lives.
You can also drive adoption by rewarding the right behavior.
This could be as simple as tracking the end user who provides the maximum feedback for knowledge-based articles and rewarding them with a small goodie bag from IT.
This will not only encourage others to adopt this behavior, but also win some brownie points for the IT team.
Improve experience.
Okay, now everyone in the company has adopted self-service. What's next? You make sure they come back. Remember, your end users are just one bad experience away from going back to the old ways, like calling you, walking up your desk, or leaving post-it notes.
Here are some ways in which you can improve the experience. Act on feedback.
Set up an effective feedback channel right from the beginning.
Analyze each feedback and create a plan for how and when you can act on it.
Stay updated.
Update your self-service offering with new information and items quickly. If someone wants to request for a brand new software your company just bought, they should find it in the catalog.
If they don't, end users will quickly assume that the self-service experience is outdated and will not return.
Assign an internal owner.
The owner can act as the project manager for your self-service experience and maintain it going forward. There you go, the 4 steps required for a successful self-service implementation. But there is one more important step. You've gone through all the effort to launch the self-service experience, so don't forget to celebrate with your team. This can seem like a lot, but just like the insanely user-friendly London Underground, the user happiness this creates is unparalleled. Thanks for watching. If you like our video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. For more useful content, enroll in Freshworks Academy. The link is in the description. Until next time, bye and happy supporting.